Welcome.
Dang it. Oh, I was singing a church song.
I know.
That also can work.
Hello, friends. It's nice to be here.
Welcome for real. We are so delighted you're here. And we're not sure how this is going to go with four of us because sometimes we can be a hot mess. I don't know.
We'll try really hard not to talk over each other.
I'll just keep my mouth shut.
All of these things would solve everything. Okay, so I'll give you a little quick introduction of who we are and what we're doing, and then we'll just dive right in. We are Becky Higgins. I am Becky Higgins, but we, the company, this is part of us. This is like half of us.
Hashtag Team Becky.
Hashtag Team Becky. That's us. And Toni is here, and she's watching for your comments and questions, so please chime in and let us know where you're watching from, because we love to know that. And let us know what ideas that you have to contribute once we get going in this conversation about summer survival, because we're all feeling it. We're feeling
almost
it.
Almost 2 weeks in now.
2 weeks in.
2 weeks in.
For us. We're here in Arizona. And here, Monique, do you mind? All right, we're going to introduce Monique in a second. Woo, thank you.
It's heinous.
Toni just talked.
Is it summer? It's
heinous.
Summer.
Heinous.
Thanks, Wendy. The weather.
It referring to the weather.
We just stay inside so then I can still wear my jean jacket.
And we do keep it very cool in here. Yeah. But regardless, it's summer. We're in Arizona. It's probably 110 today.
106, actually. 106. It's supposed to be 106. Cooling down, I think Monday's only going to be in the 90s.
Ooh! What?
I know. True story. I heard
it's
it.
Oh my gosh. That's
I know. The winds are coming
in.
We
can wear boots. And our parkas.
Yeah. All of the jeans back out. Back away the shorts, people.
This is going to go really well.
Tuesday, Monday, the high is 92.
Yeah, I told you.
That's crazy. Wow. I'm wearing a sweater. Uggs all around.
Wow. We're going to celebrate.
Yeah, we are.
I won't be here.
You won't be here.
But I will text you all and so celebrate.
We have Tracy from Portland.
Hey, Tracy. Oh, Portland.
Hey, I'm from Portland. And
I'm
so
a Portland girl,
Harry.
Yeah.
Portland girl.
And I've had family that's lived there.
And I've heard of it.
We have Sarah from Tucson, Wendy from
Tucson.
California.
I was in Tucson yesterday, Sarah.
Sean's here.
Hey, Sean.
Hi, Sean. Irene.
And then we have, there's two names. So it's Chris and Tim.
Hi, Chris and Tim.
She said that she ordered shirts for her and her daughter.
Yay! Oh, let's talk about that. Sure. Okay. See what we're wearing? You like it? Rise and
you
shine.
You can get one.
Rise and shine.
Is there a roll? I have a song for that.
We all have the rolls. Yeah, I know. Okay, so if you don't know what the shirts are, Rise and Shine. This is our shirt that we designed that is available through Sense of Style. So you can go to mysenseofstyle.com. You can find it. Just search Rise. It'll just pop right up. And we love them. There's a whole message behind this. So go to my blog at beckyhiggins.com and search Rise, Rise and Shine, anything of the like. And you will see the whole meaning behind this shirt. It's very special. We love it. And we decided to wear it today.
Yeah.
Why not?
And they are the most comfortable shirts. They are so soft and
they
fit
really,
really well.
And I think I know a lot of people ask about sizing. I think their sizes fit truly fair to size as well.
I'm wearing a large. I'll just stand up. So this is large on me. And I'm 5'4", just showing you where it hits. I love the fit.
Mm-hmm. I'm a medium.
And it still goes to my knees.
And yet, I'm a medium as well. So this one is a medium.
So, bottom
I'm a normal person. Same size. And I'm an extra large, so there you go.
So, yeah, it's just kind of nice to know who's wearing what size, because everyone has different body types. And so, I actually am going to pick one up for my daughter, who's 11, but I think she's a women's adult small, or extra small, something like that. Mm-hmm. And probably get small, because then if it shrinks a little bit, and so she can grow into it. So anyway, head over there and check it out. That's not even what we're talking about, but we decided to look so cute today.
We're going to definitely go out in public like this.
Yeah.
For sure.
All of us.
We should go run a race together.
We are going to run a race together.
We could talk about
that's a whole other topic. What we're really talking about today is summer survival tips. So if you're new to us, everything that we do ties back to cultivating a good life and recording it. So the recording it part has to do with Project Life, preserving memories, memory keeping, what do you do with your photos, all of that. But the cultivating a good life part of it is just everything under that umbrella of what are we doing every day in and day out, to just do our very best to cultivate a good life. We have choices every day, right? Monique, we were just talking about that with her. Every day to do good things. And so on that note, and that's summer survival tips, look, we are working moms.
Yes, we are.
struggle is real.
We have a lot of kids.
I know.
Who knows
even
what's going
my,
on in our homes right
saying,
now?
Even if my husband thinks that I come to the office and just party all day, because he thinks that sometimes. But
yeah. But we do actually work.
Yes.
We do actually get a whole lot done.
Yes.
And the struggle is real. And that balance of, like, what do you do with kids, whether you're working or not. Like, summer can be tricky. It can be the best ever, but it can be tricky. And so before we dive into that, let's introduce Monique really quick. Is that cool?
Yeah.
So okay. Come on, Monique.
I don't have on
the
black and white shirt.
I wish we had confetti that could, like, spill down from the ceiling. Or
we just do have jazz hands at her.
Yeah.
Oh, my gosh. Did we do it well?
Awesome.
Should we get a picture?
Are you ready?
Wait.
One more time.
Are you ready?
Yes.
Okay.
Oh, my gosh.
That was
for a picture. Sorry, that was for a picture.
Right, they're all like, why are you looking over there?
So we love Monique, and she's a customer. She is, like so many of you, just she's been following for a while, and maybe you should tell, like, what's the story of you with this company in less than 60 seconds?
I have the very first kit.
Nice.
Oh, I should do my side profile.
And probably everyone.
I forgot. I told myself I was like,
many ponytails today.
Oh my gosh. It's so bad,
tails.
You guys. But hey, there it is. I put it on Instagram stories. Okay.
It's like a mullet. Yeah, exactly. I have the very first kit and lots in between. And mostly now I scrapbook in the app all the time.
Oh, grab it. Let's just do this right now.
I have a fantastic husband who gifted me with this ginormous iPad
for
Christmas 1 year
so
that I could scrapbook in my bed.
Look at the monstrous, amazing, beautiful size that is. Okay, so
the iPad Pro.
If you have an iPad Pro, this is the 12.9-inch size. This page is 8x8.
In real life.
Real size 8x8.
What? That's amazing. I didn't even know that.
For anybody that wanted it on their Mac, that's not going to happen, but this can happen. So.
And can't you attach a keyboard to that?
Oh,
this case right here.
My case is a keyboard.
Oh.
I have a good husband. I got the whole nine, people.
Wow.
Yeah. Oh, just
that's
what?
The case that Steve has as well.
So
that
I just put it on my lap in my bed.
That's so cool.
In my bed.
I think this is going to be one of the biggest things of this broadcast.
That should be.
I know. That's
a
we're done. I think this is it. We're done. We will feature this as a favorite by our friend Monique.
Yes.
Thank you. Right there.
Yes. So
okay.
So my summer survival tip is I spend most of the day working, and then I spend my evenings with my children. But once they're all tucked in bed, I can open up my ginormous iPad in my bed and scrapbook.
Yay!
We love
every way to spend the summer.
She is a customer, very loyal, loves Project Life, but she's our friend.
Yeah, like
we love her.
Well, and she's come to Arizona several times and popped in. And
she can't not
just,
pop in.
Yeah.
She comes and we love
right.
it. And she makes our day and today really like made our life.
Pretty much.
We just love her. So anyway, our customers.
And I love you.
Yeah. Thanks. We feel it. So she's here, and I'm sure she might have a tip to share as well. Are you allowed to share what you do?
I think that's really cool.
That's a fun fact. You should know because everyone, like, you know.
And where are you from?
Yeah. Okay, you're visiting us from.
I'm visiting you from Wyoming. If you want to follow me on Instagram, I mostly post about Becky Higgins. I'm YOWYO_girl. In real life, I am a prosecutor, and I prosecute people who abuse their children mostly. So, kind of a big, heavy job. I also am a mom. I have 5 kiddos who range in age from 21 to 5 because I want to parent forever. I would say my summer survival tip is drinking, but I actually don't drink, so.
Drink cold water. Lots of cold water.
Cold water, a lot of ice.
Sonic ice. There
yes,
you go.
Yes. That's funny.
But honestly, one of the things that Monique was sharing with us this morning is one of her, like, real-life survival things. Because she has a highly stressful job. Can you even imagine doing
she
what
is
she
a
does?
Superhero. Yeah.
She really,
is a
like,
superhero.
Right, it's
her
my job.
I
have a cake today.
It's just tucked in.
But one of your life survival tips or your life hacks is that you do spend your downtime with us. Like,
that's right.
Like, on social media, knowing she knows that she can come here and find positivity, basically, and feel good things and learn neat things, and she expressed that to us this morning, and it means a lot to us that's how she spends her downtime.
Yeah,
I know. We're like, we have fresh makeup on, Monique. Thanks a lot.
Sorry, I wanted to wreck everybody's makeup because
have my sunburn, so I didn't need it today.
Anyway, thank you.
All right, I'm going to go
so
sit.
Cool. All right, so we'll dive right into talking about summer survival, and we really do invite you to join and just express some things that you would like to share on what helps you. Should we start by kicking off with what I saw Shay
I think so.
Share?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
I think it's perfect.
I feel like my water cup is super cute, but very distracting.
Very green.
And that's,
green.
I know. My daughter gave this
it's
for
so
me
cute.
For our Mother's Day. They call me Mom. Yeah. Like my shirt. Anyway. All right. So I'm scrolling Instagram one day, which I don't do very much lately. So this was like, I was meant to come across this. My friend who we're not real life friends, we're cyber friends on Instagram, we're Insta friends. Her name is Shay Cochran. She's a photographer and amazing artist and photographic artist in Florida. And she shared something that I caught, and it's long. You know, sometimes the longer posts, like many of the ones that I write, it's just kind of easy to skim by. I felt like I should read this, and I'm so glad I did, because it really plays into what we are talking about today. She says, I think there is something to be said about having a plan that helps you to do the things that you really want to do with your kids or otherwise over the summer. But I'm going to stick my neck out there and say that I also sense among our generation of young moms a new burden being sewn into the fabric of summer break. And that is this idea that we need to strive to summer well, to have it all mapped out, to execute it well, have enough plan to keep everyone happy, to make sure we are doing what matters and redeeming the time, checking off lists to prove that we have had fun, and somehow quantify that summer was a success. Talk to a mom or grandmother who raised little children 30, 40, or 50 years ago and try to explain to her the way we approach summer with all of its checklists and make sures, and you will likely get a laugh and a very different perspective. Of course, I'm still reading at this point because I'm like, yes, where is she going? Have we taken what it was meant to be a gift of a short season of rest and margin and slower living and filled it in a way that turns it into another law to measure how we are performing as moms? I don't have the answers. I'm sitting in that tension. I'm challenging my own propensities as I enter the first true day of summer in our home. I will tell you what's at the top of my list, though. Just enjoying my girls. I have goosebumps as I'm reading this, you guys. And enjoying more time to do the little things that get pushed out of our busy school year calendars. Allowing for mess and boredom and empty time and just being present there and savoring the gift of a season of slow without trying to turn it into another thing to accomplish well. What?
Mic drop.
That, like, I still have goosebumps. I can't, like, thank goodness because it's hot outside. I am so moved and touched that Shay not just felt this, but she, using her public platform of social media, just like we have, was willing to, as she says, put her neck out there and just say this, because I think we do live in a time in a season of Pinterest moms. Mm-hmm. Nothing wrong with looking to social media for inspiration, trying to do cute things. I think that's all great. It's actually really cool. At the same time, what do you guys think? Like, have we lost the art of just slowing down and just letting the summer season be what it is? I don't know if you guys have thoughts on that.
Somebody specifically asked if we could share that. So maybe we have to share.
We will. Yes.
To Shay.
Yes.
I think we could share that.
Yeah. I will. So can you write that down? Really. I'll connect with Shay personally and just make sure that we can, like, reshare that, because, yeah, we will.
Yeah, awesome.
Yeah. Anyway, who has a thought on that? Like, is
I
that,
do.
Yeah,
I
please.
Say amen to what she said. Like, oh, yeah. I do. And I think a part of that is because of social media, and we see what other people are doing, and we see the places that they're going, and we see the things that they're doing with their families. And I think that our kids are seeing that too, especially those of us that have teenagers. And so my poor kids who are sitting at home half the day while I'm either at work or it's too hot to go do something or whatever, or I just frankly don't want to spend $50 to go do some sort of activity outside of our home, my kids are sitting in the house watching Netflix on Instagram going, wow, they're at Wet n Wild, or they're in Mexico with their friends, or they're doing whatever. And they're comparing their summer to their friend's summer, and I think social media just stirs it up even more.
And there's
sure.
nothing inherently wrong about going on a great
Absolutely
trip and
not.
Sharing. It's just what kind of happens from that, or is what, huh?
No, that was my weird. Big thing, is that exactly what Carrie said. With teenagers, it's a little, because we have littles, and that's one problem, but this adds to the problem of summering well. Like, where did we summer? Inside.
Right.
Our house. Where it's cooler.
Yeah.
Laurie said. For some of our team members aren't here, but Laurie said it's okay for your kids to be bored. Let go of the Pinterest idea of summer. We don't have to provide amazing blockbuster entertainment for our kids every day. I think if we do that, we rob them of the ability to be creative and to fill their own time. Mm-hmm. Yes, like so much that. I mean, I think we've all fallen into that trap where our kids are like, I'm bored. What can I do? And I'm like, okay, you're bored. Then go figure something out.
Yeah.
Because I'm not going to.
That's what we did.
Yeah.
That's what we did.
Well, when you say, well, we've got a lot of stuff we can do.
Totally.
Yeah. Yeah. And we've got a whole list of stuff in the house.
Speaking of lists, because I mean, I'm a big fan of the list, and there's nothing wrong with the list during summer. I actually have a couple things to share on that. But there are things that you can do that are productive.
Mm-hmm. Totally.
Or, you know, whatever, that's great. But there is something to say. I mean, as I grew up as a kid, I spent countless hours on a bike. My parents didn't know where we were.
Oh, yeah,
I was frolicking in the woods behind my house, just playing. Like, that's what we did. Mm-hmm. Gone are those days. We realize it's different now, and that's fine. It's 2017, and I'd be the first one to say I'm way more protective than I, you know, probably need to be. But you know, I feel protective. But having said that, back to the note about creativity, my daughter, Claire, who's 11, and Crew, 8, were home for a good chunk of yesterday by themselves and were so creative. And I'm like, because they're inclined to be on the screen. Like, come on. Like, they all have technology. Yeah. It's great. They love Netflix and Studio C on YouTube. And, like, there's some good stuff. But I wanted them to just, like, minimize the screen time. Claire took some of our stone wrap, which is, if you don't know, the gift wrap, it's made out of stone, not paper. It's amazing. So it's great for crafting and creativity. And she made this whole, like, I don't even know what to call it. Claire, what do you call it? She's here. Oh, she might, my daughter's here, but she might have headphones in. Anyway, she created this thing that's literally like the size of a huge bulletin board, and she created all of these things on it, so it's basically her super board, because she's a super girl now, because of all of the movies. That are, you know,
where she is, Wonder Woman.
Wonder Woman, yeah. Like, and it has all these buttons and things to push in pockets and a place for her snack. And I mean, I need to take a picture and share it on social media.
Yes, you do.
I will. It's super, super cool. And like, I visually, I'm like, oh, more stuff on her walls. Like, look at my skin crawl. But I'm like, yes, creativity for the win. Yes, spend time doing that. Anyway,
we have a really good comment from Marilyn. She just wrote. She said, my summer goal is to spend time with my daughter and, yes, to do some things together, but not to be on the go, but rather to connect, to do the normal routine daily things together rather than me doing them without helping her, to teach her to cook, to spend lazy days with family and friends and no agenda.
Marilyn, that is awesome. Awesome.
Yes.
That is so cool, Marilyn. Thank you for sharing that.
Someone, and then Julie just chimed in and said, my grandma always told us not to say the B word.
Bored.
Or we would have to do chores that worked real fast for us to find something else, something to do or play.
Yep. The quote I always use with my kids, if that, and that is a word that actually doesn't get said because they've learned at such a young age. I'm like, boring or bored people are boring people.
Yeah,
if
that's
you
what
truly,
I say too.
Do you?
Well, then you're super boring.
Yeah. There's a ton of stuff to do.
Oh my gosh, there's always so much to do, and especially if you foster that creativity.
Right,
And so if you have kids who are, I guess that is one tip that kind of comes out of this. If you have kids who are saying they're bored and they're not used to this, you know, like creativity thing, just challenge them, work with them in positivity, and provide them with literally scraps of stuff. I mean, Claire is on cloud 9 if she finds some random fabric or something that we're about to throw away or donate. She's like, can I cut that up? You know, and that's because of fostering it and cultivating those opportunities to, like, be creative. So put out supplies and stuff and say, create something. Good luck. Make a contest out of it.
Well, I love what she said about teaching her daughter to do things. There's a lost art of handing down recipes and how your grandmother used to cook for you.
Homemaking in general.
Yeah, and so I've told my kids, our situation is a little bit different. I was a stay-at-home mom for 16 years. Then things changed with the economy, and I went to work. And so my younger children had a different experience than my older children. And I kind of dropped the ball. They don't know how to do a lot of things that my older kids, and my older kids coming back home are like, Mom, you need to teach them. And so that's why I told them, we're learning that this summer. They're going to know how to do, they do their laundry, but not the way that I would like them to. Mm-hmm. So laundry, cooking meals, all of that.
I was going to say, and that's one thing that we've done actually in the summer, just because we do have a little bit more time. And that's where I will assign each child one night. So we'll say like Monday is the night of the week that one of the kids is going to cook. And then each child has a different Monday that's assigned to them or whatever day of the week.
Right.
And then they choose what it is that we're going to have. They make sure that we have what we need in the house to make it. They help me prepare it and all that kind of stuff. My oldest daughter just graduated, is getting ready to leave for college, and she's like, Mom, you need to teach me to make cinnamon rolls. You need to teach me to make this. And I said, make a list of the things that you want to learn how to make so that when you are on your own, you know the things that you ate at home or that we made at home that you loved. Make that list, and then we will start planning out what days of the week that we're going to learn to do those things.
Love it.
You're going to write down the recipe. You'll take it with you. And actually, I just we've been going through getting our house ready to sell. And one of the things, I was decluttering just cookbooks, and I use very few cookbooks anymore because I keep most of my recipes on my iPad. I have a program that I use. But I found this book, and it was called What Do I Do Now That Mom's Not Here? Or something like that. Anyway, it was published in, like, 1989. It is literally a book that my mom gave to me when I left to go to college. There's a little note on the inside of it from my mom. So I wrote a note to my daughter on the inside of it, and I gave it to her, and I said, this is a book that my mom gave me when I left to go to college, and now I'm giving it to you. And it is not only a cookbook, but there's a section at the back of it that has tips on doing laundry, removing stains, changing a tire, like all those kinds of things. And I'm like, here you go, because she's getting ready to leave. And so, anyway,
that is actually, we're not talking about summer survival.
Sorry, that wasn't summer survival.
No, like, we're talking about, that is the coolest tradition.
Yeah.
That just your mom kind of started that she probably didn't even realize.
Totally.
Because now you're passing that on.
There you go. I will find out if it's still in publication.
Oh my gosh.
When it was published in 1989, right when I was graduating high school. But yeah, loved it.
I'm inspired.
Wow. On that note, my mom made all of us in the family for Christmas years ago, one year, a photo book, and she took my grandma's recipe. When I say my grandma, like, my fudge is my grandma's fudge. Like,
yeah.
She could cook, and she grew up in Mexico, and she could make tamales, and anyway, awesome food, but we all would always be calling each other, what's grandma's? My mom got all of her recipes and took pictures of them, so they're in my grandmother's handwriting in this book.
That's priceless, that book is super cool. I love it. Okay, let's dive into more, like, practical tips of things that we can do. Besides food-based ideas, because we're all about that. And we all kind of brought to the table, like, kind of, literally, just ideas of what you could do. Did you want to share a couple from because Wendy Burley, our friend Wendy, she brought up a great idea. I thought this was fun.
Yeah, so this is fun. Our friend Wendy Burley, who's done some photography for us, she uses a punch card for her kids. So the punch card has different things on it, like reading for 30 minutes, exercising for 30 minutes, certain chores, making the bed, brushing teeth. And each day, once they've done each of those things, they punch it off. And once they have a full punch card, they get to turn it in for a prize or like a $5 gift card to Sonic or to Bahama Bucks. Or just, she has a little bin of prizes and little things that kind of motivates them to make sure they're getting those things done. But then, I don't know about your kids, but mine always want to meet their friends at Sonic or Bahama Bucks or whatever. And instead of throwing them money, they've earned this little gift card to go do that. So that is a super fun idea that she had.
It's tangible. Yeah. Like the kids, when she brought that up, I'm like, I could totally picture doing that. And I'm actually not. Really like went home with that on my to-do list and went, never mind, I'm not going to. But for her, like, you could tell her kids love it. Mm-hmm. It's, you physically punch through those things that you've accomplished and win awards,
right?
Or rewards. Yeah. I think it's really cool.
Very fun.
Okay, Tony, do you want to chime in with something?
Sure.
Okay, come on in.
This is more of
Here's Tony.
And please notice her skirt. I mean, can we just please?
Oh my gosh, this is so old.
Like,
Target,
so
like, years ago.
I know, but for real.
Okay.
T-shirt with a pencil skirt.
I know, I'm comfortable. Mm.
Okay.
Okay, so this was just my life hack. So I have three kids, and when they were little, I had twins, and then they were 18 months old, I had another one, so they're all really close together. And so I used to schedule their summer swim lessons at 11:30, so then it was over at noon, and then I would pack a little lunch, and we would eat lunch, and then swim for like an hour, so then they were nice and tired, and then I would bring the shampoo and conditioner, because I didn't want them to go home with chlorine hair, and we would go in the little shower there at the pool and shower, so then they would come home and go right down for a nap.
All fresh and clean.
All fresh and clean.
Fresh, clean,
and tired.
Yep. And you weren't messing up your shower at your house either.
No,
which is super
true.
Nice.
But my thing was when I had kids that young and that close in age, is I needed to renew me. That was like my renewal time, was their nap time. That's
why they need to watch Oprah too.
Naptime is a non-negotiable.
Yeah, yeah. Naptime was it was. Yeah. I was a nap. I was not the I made sure they nap for a very long time
about your naps.
So anyway, so that's my little life hack is
I love that.
Bring the shampoo and conditioner to the pool.
Brilliant.
And it was a really nice life. Really nice public swimming pool. Anyways.
Hey.
That's awesome.
It was good.
Nice.
That's good. Now they're 2 are 19 and 1 is 18. So now they all have a car and they all have a job, and so I'm like, just make sure that you're home by curfew.
Keep yourself
survival.
Survival.
Make
yourself.
I know.
Now her summer survival is find my friends so she can keep track of where her teenagers are when they're not home.
That's a good hack right there.
I follow my kids all over the place.
Yeah. What other tips do you guys want to bring up? I've got a list.
I'll say one of mine is my kids cannot have any screen time before 10 a.m. There's no exceptions. There's nothing, no exception to the rule at all. I put this into place years ago because I didn't want them waking up at 6 in the morning, getting their chores done, and then having the TV on at 7 a.m. And so this totally has made my kids all sleep in. None of them want to wake up at 6 in the morning to get their chores done and then sit there for 4 hours.
Okay, interesting. So, and what's interesting is we did something similar, not a screen time thing, but with my son, he was that early,
yeah.
Like would get up so early. And so we started one summer with an alarm clock.
Oh, yeah.
And he had an alarm, and he could not leave his bedroom until his alarm went off.
Yeah.
Which was like, I think, 8 o'clock in the morning or something like that. Totally. And so if he woke up at 6, he could sit in his room and play with his toys for 2 hours if he wanted, but he could not leave his bedroom until the alarm went off.
Wow.
And
yeah.
So it was like that signal for him, because then I wasn't having to manage or whatever, you know, not that that's a problem, but like the morning time for us was like a time to like get ourselves ready and all that kind of stuff. And so, you know, when you have little kids wandering out, but the alarm clock worked wonders for him.
Yeah.
That's so cool.
And
we did
something similar with some of ours. And I use this rule on holidays and weekends and everything because to me it's like they're going to have enough screen time eventually in the day. I don't keep them. That was the other thing I was going to say. I am not super, super strict with their screen time. Sometimes if they need a day to binge watch a TV show, more power to them. I wish I could do that. And I think for 10 months of the year, they're in school 8 hours a day.
Yeah.
They're in homework and dance and sports and all that stuff that I don't limit their screen time too much. I mean, I definitely do, but that 10 a.m., I've even kind of maybe been pushing it to 11 recently just because I want them to have, because they're sleeping in longer. I mean, they're getting older and they are sleep until 9:30. I'm like, well, we'll push it to 11 so then you can get your reading done and your chores and all that kind of thing, because they still can't have the screens till their chores are done, but if they're done by 10, then that's exactly.
I'm the same way in terms of relaxing during the summer about that. Like I thought that I was going to be a better mom years ago if I limited and made it very structured and you only have certain time, and I'm like, why
yeah.
Summer, like you said, 2 months of the year, because that's literally what it is for us here in Arizona. Our kids were out of school by May 24th, something like that.
By Memorial Day.
So it's basically Memorial Day weekend, and then you have June and July. And then we're back in school the 1st of August. So 2 months is just short. And in our family, we're gone a lot, and we're traveling, and we literally, like, we escape the heat as much as we possibly can, because we are intentional about that, and we build that into my husband's time off and things like that. But when we're home, like, today's a typical day of, and crew quarters at camp, and crew's at the water park with a friend, and I brought Claire here with me to the office. Like, we're just flexible, and so screen time just has to fit into that flexibility. Mm-hmm. Like, it's fine.
For
like,
sure.
Like you said, you wish you could sit around and binge watch a whole show. Like, that sounds great. It's summer. Relax.
I just like to sleep all day.
Truthfully.
I'd like one day to just sleep.
You know what my dream is? One day during the summer, not to sleep, but no one else in my family is there.
Yes.
And it's my house.
I've had that
just,
all week.
Yes, you have.
Yes.
Like, the amount of things I would accomplish, and I don't mean cleaning out closets.
Yeah.
I like to do that kind of stuff with my family because I want them involved. But scrapbooking specifically, like some projects I want to do that just, I want to focus and turn on La La Land soundtrack and just go without any distractions. I wouldn't even eat.
Yes, you
would. Bring me some
cinnamon
rolls.
I always order all my favorite foods.
And I've been binge watching Old Survivor.
I know.
Have you?
Yes, and it's awesome. It's so, I have the whole house to myself.
If you guys have a suggestion for something other than Old Survivor.
I love Survivor.
No, I know, that's great. But because you have this time, if you guys have a suggestion for binge watching something, Sharon.
She's already caught up with This Is Us, so don't say that. And she just finished Gilmore Girls, too.
I haven't seen that.
Oh, I haven't either.
What?
You have to.
This Is Us?
No, you have to.
Watch This Is Us.
Yes.
The first episode is like, wait, guy with the towel over his, like, what? Because it really, like, the first episode of all the episodes is the one I'm like, they got slightly, like, and, you know, I maybe wouldn't choose.
So good.
So good.
Okay, so... Yes, my husband and three kids are all out of town on a church trip all week, so I've been by myself, which has been
fun.
It's been a day by yourself.
It is.
I'm so sorry for you.
It's so awesome.
Monique's like, had I known, I would have come home with Tony.
I know.
So right when they come home, though, right as soon as they come home, I am leaving to go out with three girlfriends to go see Move Live with Derek Huff. Okay. So I'm asking right now, if any of you have a connection to Derek Huff, you need to message me, because I have to meet him tomorrow.
Hi, Swan.
I was gonna say, did you see that? Oh,
I need to see that. Oh yeah. So, anyways, just throwing that out there.
Yeah. So this is a live thing.
Yes, it's a dance. It's him and his sister. Yes. A dance thing.
Yeah.
It's my dream.
This is your dream.
She might make out with him if she needs.
Derek Huff.
If you're watching,
I will take him out to dinner tomorrow.
If you're watching, to Grimaldi.
Come down.
More girls watch it. Someone in Parenthood watched it.
Yeah.
Okay. I just
How I Met Your Mother. Have you watched it?
What?
How I Met Your Mother?
Have not.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh.
That's
okay.
That's a good one.
Okay. Other good suggestions.
Yeah.
Okay. Should I talk about some of my?
Yeah. Let's go back over. I have a long list, but
I was told to bring two ideas, which is what I brought.
I just said everyone should probably bring at least two ideas. Okay. So we had something, and I was on the plane yesterday, and so my list got a little bit longer. But mine aren't. These aren't like full explanation things. These are just specific things that I have on my summer to-do list that I would... Are you thinking about it? What's happening?
I don't know.
Just read it.
Isn't that fun?
No, your kids are so excited.
I'm dying to know how to do it. Scrub the toilet.
Okay. Let me explain something.
The audience is on the edge of their seat now. Oh,
it's the first one. You better go.
That's on my list too. Okay, I'll say something.
Yeah, go ahead.
One thing I do is Costco has these workbooks for every grade, first grade, second grade, third grade, and I have bought them every year for my kids, and they're required to do a certain number of pages or 30 minutes of time in their workbooks just to keep their brains moving, and they all have loved it. I didn't do it this year. They're getting old, so I didn't do it this year. I'm like, here's your freshman year high school workbook. But anyway, for my kids, up until last year, and I still have, anyway, they love it. They actually, because sometimes it's fun things or it's math problems. It's a good mix, so.
She
used to be a teacher.
Yeah. No, but I was a teacher, but I'm actually not even that mom. I don't want to be that mom. But
you are that mom, and it's admirable. Yeah. I think that's a great idea.
I'm sure your kids are smarter than mine.
I bet it results in awesome things. Like, I do. I think that's really cool.
Okay,
my children.
Lori, hold on. Our Lori.
Hi, Lori.
Wants to know.
Lori.
If that's a list for how they can be more spontaneous.
Lori, that was awesome.
Yes.
Lori. You win. Okay, you guys. This is not like.
Our list of spontaneity.
This is not. That's actually really funny. Okay, Lori and everyone. This is not a list of what I think my kids would have fun doing. That's not what I'm trying to accomplish here. What I have in mind as I was writing down some of the things that are like on my to-do of the summer is, in addition to and coupled with, in tandem with, total chill and downtime. Ask my kids how much chill time they get. They get plenty of chill time.
Yeah.
I believe in balance. And so there are some things that have to get done. They will clean out their closets. That is the first thing on the list. I am using summer to, this is not new, we do this at least twice a year, where it's me and you, one-on-one, me and child, out your closet, and we power through for a good 20 minutes, and that's all it takes, and it's done. They grow constantly, right? So that's on my list. But this one I'm really excited for. If they even think about possibly feeling bored, I will ask them to initiate something that will be ongoing through the summer, and that is that each of them will have an 8.5 by 11 piece of white cardstock. I have laughed and cried today. I just realized that I'm just going to just be toast. An 8.5 by 11 white piece of cardstock, and they are going to fill it with 100 things that they are grateful for. This doesn't take a whole lot of explanation.
Cool. Well, it's like a mini size of your grateful poster.
Yes, kind of. And yeah, if you if you go to my blog and search grateful, you'll see the blog post where this is a thing that we did in our home, and it's still one of my favorite things that we have on our wall. And my whole strategy in that is to instill, always, to keep instilling gratitude. Gratitude is the parent of all the virtues, in my opinion. And that's a quote from someone who I don't know who. And I believe that. I believe that the more grateful you are, the better you are as just a human being. Right. And all of the virtues that we want to have. And the core values. So anyway, I just thought that's just an easy summer thing when we're on the road or they're at home and they're just wanting to shift from Studio C to, you know, something else. Write what you're grateful for. Okay. Kind of. You okay with this?
Yeah.
List? Okay. My kids
you're
are having more
all
fun.
Mine.
I'll share one more and then we'll bounce on a little bit more. Another one is that we are actually going to, one of our we don't know if it's going to be Porter or Claire. We're still going to see, but probably Porter, who's 14, is going to have a paid job, paid by us, to scan all of our scrapbooks, all of our physical scrapbooks. We have a Big Daddy scanner that I haven't even talked about. It's from Fujitsu, which is the same as the ScanSnap, but it's just, it's kind of more expensive, and it's something where you can just set a book down, and it's kind of looks like an overhead projector, and you can feel free to search it, but I haven't done a review on it because I haven't gotten into it yet. I have to see how it works, but we're going to pay Porter because it's a lot of time that I don't have to spend doing it, or that David doesn't have to spend doing it, going through all of our family scrapbooks, and you guys may remember that we have a few around the house. It's going to be a lot of time, and he's going to take them out one by one, and he is going to see more about our life.
That's
than
great.
Ever.
That's
so
cool. Yeah,
so I'm actually excited, and it's a win-win because he's going to get paid.
Totally.
It's going to be fair. It's a great job. Let me stop there. Somebody else jump in with another idea.
Karen, do
you have okay. Yeah. So one thing that we have started doing this summer, I saw ideas somewhere, things to do with your kids. I don't know.
Pinterest.
But was it Pinterest? I don't call them Pinterest, actually. Sorry.
Anyway.
I know it's shocking to people, but I just don't. One thing we're doing is
it's so shocking.
We've implemented a
it is hot in here.
Family game
hot
night.
Hot
so
here.
So every night
here?
Can you turn it down?
Every night before Every night before we go to bed, we have implemented a family game night. And so one of the kids will choose a game. Uno and Skip-O tend to be the most popular, but we also have like headbands and apples to apples, just things that are simple that everybody in our family can play because we range in age from me being the oldest to my youngest being 10.
She would like you to know that she's also the oldest here at the office.
I am not.
Yes. No,
Tony
she's
is older.
Not.
Oh,
sorry.
Oh.
I am older than Wendy.
That's what I'm thinking.
And Wendy has two grandbabies. But
yes.
But basically what happens is whoever is home, because, you know, there's a lot of times my oldest is working late at night or we have one that's out with friends or whatever, but whoever is home sits down around the table and we play a game at night before the kids go to bed. And my kids have loved it so much. My 10-year-old is the first one to be like, oh, what are we playing tonight? What are we playing tonight? Like,
I love that.
They love it. And it is a time where there's no phones out. There's no TV on. There's nothing. But it's time for us to just sit around and we talk and we laugh. And it's just so great.
That's true.
It's
connection.
So great.
We're really connecting as a family.
Yes. Yeah. And it's so easy during the school year because we are busier and kids have different practices, different times, and everybody's getting home at a different time, and it just makes it so tricky. And we used to be better about trying to do it, like, on Sunday evenings, we'd sit down and play a game. But even then, just with what Steve has had going on, like, there's just been a lot of time when we just weren't all there to do it. And so, it's just something we decided we were going to do this summer, and it's totally been so, so fun.
I love that.
So cool.
That's super inspiring.
Yeah. Yeah.
And I think some families are more game inclined.
Mm-hmm.
Like when you brought that up, I'm like, I should totally try that. I even wrote it down. Mm-hmm. All these ideas I'm writing down and I'm not implementing. But our family doesn't love games as much. We'll play them once in a while. We especially love them with other families. Mm-hmm. Yeah. But with just ours, I'm like, I don't think that's one that's just going to stick. Mm-hmm. But on that note, something that we're trying to be really as consistent as we can about is nightly scriptures together, which I know it's not as fun as games. I know that. But speaking of connecting, that is, as a mother, that is my favorite thing that we try to do as a family every night. Is and we're not great about every night. We try.
Yeah.
And summer is all over the place. But if we can read our scriptures and say prayer together, that is what really connects us.
Mm-hmm.
And we don't just read scriptures. We
right.
talk about it.
Right.
We're talking about our values and things that we believe in our faith, and we pray together. Like, what's not to love about that? So it's not the fun element, but it's the connecting element, just like the games
yeah.
are connecting.
And it might be yes. a bike ride.
Scriptures can be fun.
Or it might be a walk. Or it might be, you know what I mean? It's finding that thing, like you said, it's finding that
thing
that you do. You
yes.
know, it might be, so like, even for us, like, if it's not a game, like, let's, we're going to go for a walk in the neighborhood or whatever. But it's
yeah.
that, it's the idea or the concept of taking time to connect with each
okay.
other. Whether, like I said,
all
whether
together.
It's scriptures or a game or a bike ride or hanging out or, you know, watching a movie together
mm-hmm.
with the intention of we're all sitting down, we're not sitting on our devices,
yeah.
but we're watching a movie together.
And that is a big tip out
so.
Of what you're saying is if you're trying to be more intentional
yes.
as a parent with bringing your family together, take just be intentional about setting them away.
Yeah.
yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Put
yeah.
them in a basket or let everybody plug them into the charging station or whatever. Be intentional about it, though. Do you really have something fun about scripture reading?
Oh, like, yeah, real quick.
Yeah.
It's called, it might offend some people. What's this?
That's how Wendy rolls.
Yeah. No, every once in a while, because scripture study, especially with little kids, can get, you know.
They're super focused.
Yeah.
What are you talking about?
So we tried every once in a while. We would each do, we'd take our turn reading around the circle, family circle. We each read out loud in whatever accent we chose.
What?
And it was fun.
That's funny.
And my husband does a killer Indian accent.
Oh, my gosh,
oh,
yes.
Like, he's tricked Tony. Like, what, Tony thought he was a producer for Oprah Winfrey at one point.
Oh.
And then she was going on the show.
Like, yeah. Indian the country.
Yeah. The country,
yes.
Yes.
Oh,
anyway.
That was funny.
So that was fun. And we also have read to a quotation. So they have to be watching and reading along. So if there's a comma, then the next person reads.
Oh.
And anyway,
okay.
That's for younger kids.
So that was just
not a quotation.
Punctuation.
Thank you.
Marcus. I get it.
I don't know geography.
What just happened?
I'm just kidding. Grammar. Right? It starts with a G.
Oh my gosh.
We really should never put all of us on camera at the same time. It just,
oh my
gosh.
Oh my gosh.
Why the laughing faces?
Anyway, just kidding.
I'm just kidding.
Hey, I'm
okay.
talking about that.
Oh my gosh, I love her.
No,
okay,
no,
have a couple. We have a couple of comments.
Don't know much biology.
But anyway.
Okay.
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 Yeah, we
have
whatever.
So Dawn chimed in and said, we have a big board. This has lots of activities on it. Each person takes a turn throwing a water balloon at it.
Oh,
it splashes on that activity. That's what we do.
Oh.
Kids can't wait to go out in the morning and get a little wet and see what we'll do.
That's
cute.
That's
cute.
And Natalie said, I bought my 5 and 7-year-old a notebook for their summer journal. Every day they have a prompt to write or draw something. It only takes them about 5 minutes,
oh,
but they look
that.
Forward to seeing what day,
totally.
What each day is, and they feel like they're using their brains for a little bit. And then she also
said,
that?
Love
that.
That
was
that.
Natalie.
Oh my gosh. Way to go, Natalie.
Hey,
that's awesome.
Natalie, so here's,
awesome.
Here's the deal, Natalie, and you already know this, but just I want to point this out. The kids aren't just using their brains. You know I'm going here. This is their personal history.
Right.
Like,
totally.
Yes, oh my thrashing amens. Like, yes to that, because what they're recording is for sure going to be that journal that they find or that they keep. They can look back at any time. But even as adults, they're going to look back at that and treasure it.
That's
amen.
Cool.
Oh, that's so
love
good.
It. Love it, love it,
that's
love it.
And then Amy jumped in and said, my daughter has created a summer bucket list. So I love it that her daughter created it.
Mm-hmm.
This
yep.
helps me to know what adventures are piquing her interest these days.
Mm-hmm.
Kids have a lot of great ideas that are often simple and require minimal resources.
Yep.
That is
so
true.
That's cool.
And then Stephanie Red Baker.
Oh.
And said, oh gosh.
My daughter. Let me really quickly say there's some cute, fun things that we have done. And my family did them when I was younger because we lived in Arizona. It's hot.
And you still do.
And yes. When your kids are little, this works. When they're bigger, not so much. But we would picnic in the living room. Like,
cute.
It was a big deal. We put a blanket on the carpet
yeah,
and have our dinner in the living room and watch, like, funniest home videos
that's
or whatever.
That's cute. That's really
that
fun.
Was fun. and you don't get heat stroke, super nice.
Always a bonus.
Then I wanted to say something else. My dad, when we were young, would read to us. Mm-hmm. And I've tried that with my family. They make fun of my reading style. But it
it's
was
whole geography
like
thing.
Reading to your children, even when they're older, yeah. He would get a novel. One of them was Jorgensen Brothers. I don't know. For you people that are of our faith might know that. Anyway, Lane and Bretton Jorgensen. Some good books.
Oh, names, yeah.
Anyway, Bishop's Horse Race was one of them. He would read the whole thing, and every night we would listen to him read.
That's so sweet.
That's like one of my favorite memories.
I love that. I tried
that a little too late with my children.
That's a good idea, though.
That's a good idea.
You could try that.
Yeah.
I got to mention who was talking about the bucket list. One of our... one of you was talking about that, and I didn't actually write that down, but that's actually a tradition that we've had many years in a row, or probably forever, is every summer, like the last day of school and kind of into that weekend, we always, I can grab it in my notebook to show you, but as a family, we brainstorm everyone's, so it's not just one person's, it's the family summer bucket list. We never get to everything, ever. Like, and we never have that expectation that we're going to. But like she's saying, like that totally gets people thinking about just anything. Mm-hmm. For me, it's about projects. Mm-hmm. I like the projects on the list. But, you know, and David actually has a few projects, but, you know, he has specific things in mind that he wants to accomplish that are fun and that are out and going somewhere, and the kids of course have little things and big things, and anyway, it's intentional though. It's a bucket list.
Something that our friend Tori, you know Tori,
yep.
did a few years ago. She decided, their family decided that they wanted to try all of the 10 best ice cream shops in the city of Phoenix.
Oh,
she went online and she found a list of like the top 10 ice cream shops. And so every week they were going to go to a different ice cream shop. And she said they only made it to number 2 because she said it was so fantastic that that's the only place they allowed you to go back to. But something like that where you choose something, either, you know, try a different fast food restaurant, the best cheeseburger, the best pizza, the best ice cream, something like that.
I love that.
Ice cream would be simple because it's usually a little bit less expensive and it feels, it's cold and it's a treat, like whatever. But I'm like, I love that.
That's
like,
really,
I think it would be
fun.
I can do that with my kids.
Yeah.
Really.
My
grown-up kids.
And it's something you're spending time in the car. So let's say that you choose an ice cream place, like for me, that's over by where Molly lives, that's, you know, 45 minutes away. That gives us an hour and a half in the car to sit and talk and visit and, you know, kind of...
Good
idea.
If you force
someone to go,
Tori,
or whatever, it's just a fun idea of
something
that, and it helps you explore your city a little bit, too.
That's what I was going to say. That's super cool. That's one of the... Hey, Race!
His door is closed.
Race, if you're watching. He has a really great idea, though, and that's why I was going to ask him. Hey, Monique, you want to go get Race?
Yeah.
Thank you. Just tell him you have
a second delay,
Okay, Race. Grace has one of the coolest ideas, and we love it, and we admire it through a specific hashtag that his wife has done on Instagram. But what do you do? How do you survive summer?
So there's this swing that they sell at IKEA, and you bolt it into the ceiling, and you can swing on it.
It's for children.
It's a children's swing.
It's not for children. It holds
Google it.
Yes.
Yes.
Swing for
children. Swing.
Indoors.
Yes.
Trust us.
Yeah. And definitely on IKEA, because goodness knows what you might get.
Right.
Exactly.
We
yes,
did
exactly.
it to test it out.
Yes. And it's super fun because
it's
learning something new every day.
It's indoors. It's not outdoors at all. That's
and it's indoors.
Yeah.
So there's that.
I missed the studs a few times.
So he may have some holes in his ceiling.
I have like 20 holes.
That's more than a few times.
Do you have a stud finder?
It's a star magnet.
I have one.
But you use it to find the screws that are in the stud, so it does work.
Okay.
So his summer survival tip is he's going to teach his children how to carpentry.
I love that. And you guys are surviving summer because you're not outside, because it's, you know.
Well, and the swing makes for great photo ops.
It's fun to photograph. The kids enjoy it. So we have two of them now for each of my toddlers, and that plus like a television in the room makes
hours of fun.
Episodes and episodes.
For sure.
Thank you.
And
I love that. Seriously. And they are the most beautiful photographs.
Yeah, they are.
That's a good one.
I like it.
Yeah. So that's nothing that we wrote down on our to-dos either, but I love that they, like, seriously, their family finds so much joy in that swing, and you can tell.
Yeah.
Like, it's really
sure.
like the
sure.
sweetest,
awesome.
Sweetest thing. I have a couple more. Do you have a couple more?
I do.
All right. Yeah.
Okay,
go.
I'll do one. So here in Arizona, we have something called Summer Movie Fun, and they do older movies for really, really cheap. I mean, we buy all the movies, 10 movies, I think, for $7 for the whole summer. But I know I go to Oregon a lot in the summer, and they have a similar thing there where it's old movies for $1 or $2.
At the theater.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And some theaters are even free. There was a theater down by me for a long time that had free kids movies, and they had, like, two showings on Tuesday and two showings on Thursday, you know, whatever.
Totally.
But a lot of theaters offer discounted.
Yeah, which I just, we have been doing it for 12 years. This is the first summer I have not bought tickets because we're going so many different directions. We'll go to a couple movies. But I have another really good tip. If you have young children, I did this when my oldest was 2 years old, 12 years ago. Bring your car seat into the theater. Even when your child is 3 or 4 years old, no matter how old they are, if they are wiggly and want to be running around, strap them into their car seat, their toddler seat. I bring that into the theater. For 10 years, I brought that into the theater with me.
Wow.
And my child always knew that once they're buckled, they don't get out of that seat. It's like being in the car. And so they would sit at the age of 2, 3, 3.5, 4, whatever, through any movie I took them into, give them a drink and popcorn, and strap them in, and they are so happy. So,
oh my gosh.
Tie your children down. Another tip when it comes to theaters, and this is summer or not summer, but it's something that we do, and that is usually the bigger bags of popcorn that you buy, at least at our theater, I go to Harkins most of the time, and they have, like, you buy the large popcorn, you get the refill for free or whatever.
$1. Or, well, if you get the big one, you got to get the big one
right.
For $1.
Right.
And then you get the free refill, and you can get the boxes.
But then we buy the plastic popcorn containers from the dollar spot at Target. I know Harkins, I think, will give you, like, free boxes or whatever.
Box.
But we just bring those. We keep them at our house. We bring them when we go to the theater. And then I take my bag of popcorn, dole it out to everybody. Get my free refill before
the movie
starts,
yes.
So I don't
right.
have to
totally.
Leave the theater during the movie.
Harkins
makes
Harkins
everybody
really
happy.
Knows how to do
we like Harkins.
They,
do.
They have
yeah.
the best popcorn, you guys. It's
really
so
quick
good.
About movies, I want to say.
Yes.
Yeah.
We have been trying, our kids are getting ready. My youngest is just going into high school, so I'm feeling very sentimental. And we have decided to force them to watch some of our favorite movies when we were young.
Ooh.
And so they don't want to.
They love it.
there's no devices. Yeah, things
yeah.
like that. But we have had them watch Quigley Down Under recently.
I don't even know.
Oh my gosh!
Oh,
it's a great movie.
Tom
Selleck.
Yeah.
Shout out to you.
Love you.
I know you're watching.
I'm sure of it.
Stop farming your avocados. Anyway.
And call Derek.
Is this how you do it?
No.
Anyway.
Yeah, it's
anyway.
A geography book.
But they love the movie. We made them watch. No devices. They have to watch the movie. And it was so good. And it's a good movie.
Oh,
Quigley Down Under.
I believe you.
80s movies with my teenagers.
Yes.
It's the best.
Love.
So
that's
fun.
So cool.
Love. It's so great.
Some of them are a little bit dirtier than we knew.
I know.
Oh, I know. But not quickly.
Be
no,
careful.
No.
Yeah, there are
dirty
definitely
dancing.
Some that you're like, oh, whoa.
Oh, yeah.
Wait, I don't remember that from when I was a teenager.
Oh.
Yeah.
I remember watching that at age 10.
Yeah. Or I was like, I can't believe my parents let me watch this.
Yeah, I know.
Oh. Trust me, there will be plenty of movies that my kids have now seen later when they have kids that will be
yeah.
like, I can't believe my
like Goonies.
Oh, yeah.
I love Goonies, but those kids had a mouth on them. Like, they were naughty. They said some words.
Careful.
They were naughty kids.
Okay, Laurie chimed in again. She said, look for Kids Bowl Free in your area. Different bowling alleys will sign
oh,
up
oh, yeah.
to be part of it, and your
yep.
kids can get so many bowling games free.
So it's
yeah.
called Kids Bowl Free?
Yeah.
Okay, so Google that. And
I think that there's a bowling alley down by us that has
yeah.
something, or at least
fun.
At least discounted bowling. Like they'll
fun.
Sell like
except for the shoes.
The shoes are stinky.
Yeah,
get your own.
Get your own bowling
yeah.
shoes.
Yeah.
You know, kind of to that point, I try so hard to find free things to do. And just today, I saw that on an email that Nectar Juice Bar is doing a free scoops tonight. I don't even know what it is. It's like anyway, something delicious. And it's free to
be there, guaranteed.
From 6 to close, everyone gets a free treat. And I'm like,
and if it's not delicious, it didn't cost you anything.
Exactly.
It's always possible.
So I'm like, I'm taking my kids to a fun place they've never been, and it's free. And like next Friday, I put it in my calendar on my phone anytime I see free things. Next Friday, Tropical Smoothie Cafe, if you wear flip-flops, you get a
free smoothie.
Anyway, so I'm always on the lookout for food stuff.
Yeah.
You need to fill
we
it.
We don't have that stuff on our side.
Oh, that's true. She lives in a different part of town.
The gas money alone.
I could just go buy smoothies. Seriously. For the coffee to get them all as part of town.
Another fun tip, something that is totally not my idea, but Claire's, again, my 11-year-old, is she has had this sudden interest in sleeping on the trampoline.
Oh,
and
wow.
We have a trampoline that has, you know, the net that zips up and stuff. So just in case of a coyote situation,
that net will protect her.
Right? Like, coyotes don't like kids anyway.
They don't.
Right?
No.
They're afraid. But that was like my main concern. Like, bug bites I can deal with, and, you know, anyway. And yeah. So once in a while, and it's usually spontaneous, my kids will just sleep on the trampoline. Which,
in Arizona,
you don't have a chance of getting cold at night.
Right.
Like, so they don't even have sleeping bags. It's like throw a pillow, a blanket, maybe.
Mm-hmm.
We even have Pippa go out. Pippa, the puppy, sleeps on the trampoline with my daughter. So that's kind of fun.
It's different.
So
we've actually set up a tent inside our house before, too. Like, we have a little 2-man tent, and Cougar desperately, I think it was right after, like, a father's and son's camp out that they weren't able to go on because it was a weekend Steve had to work or something. But he so badly wanted to go camping, and so Steve set up the little tent in Cougar's bedroom, and he kept it up for weeks. But I have friends, too, who have set up, like, their full family tent, like, cleared out their family room, set up the big family tent, they've camped in there, they've slept in there in sleeping bags and whatever. I mean, kind of a hack for Arizona, because it's really hot, or if, let's say you don't have time to trek off to the mountains to camp or whatever, but you can still make that kind of fun.
Well, one of my favorite treats for our family in the summer is s'mores in the microwave.
Yeah.
You can do it.
What?
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
It's yummy.
Like five seconds.
I know people who've done it over a gas stove as well.
Yeah.
It's just a hack when it's 1,000 degrees outside.
You really want a s'more.
You can also buy a little maker.
A
s'more
maker.
Actually, we do that.
Oh, a lighter?
We do that.
Yeah.
Lighter.
Let me know how that goes.
I'll video it.
How long are we going to take with your little lighter?
When he's like, 45 minutes later, my
marshmallow
is ready. We need time lapses.
Well,
the time lapse of
the
roasting of
the
marshmallow
runs out.
Monique, what time is it?
It is 12:06.
Oh, snap.
Did we start at 11? No, I think we started at 11.
We started a little
after.
Yeah.
We need to be done. I have one more thing I want to mention.
Okay.
Does anyone have anything else? You have another?
I have so many things on my list, but I'm going to make this a blog post. We'll
okay.
Put all of this on
yes.
the blog.
Okay. Molly's going to make it happen. For real. That's
yes.
absolutely.
We'll put all these tips.
Yeah.
To make it
we'll make it
happen.
Bullet point style. So, you know, here's all the conversation, but really the blog post will just be like a full blown list. Do you have anything else left that you want to mention here?
No.
Okay.
I'm good.
And we're good, Tony, on people who are watching comments.
We had a couple. Heather said that AC Moore has $2 crafts on Wednesdays.
Oh, that's cool.
Yeah. And then Sarah said that you can also make s'mores in the oven.
Oh, I like things in the oven.
Yeah.
Except for when you live in 1,000 degrees.
Yeah. We don't do ovens.
Hey, but have you guys seen that, like, s'mores dip where they, like, fill the pan with, like, Reese's Peanut Butter cups and then put marshmallows on the top of it and then bake it
in
the oven,
broiler,
like, on the
right?
Boiler, and then you use graham crackers to, like, scoop it out.
Have you
heard
of this?
You should make it and bring it to the office.
By the time it got here to the office, you have to eat it coming out of the oven.
Why do they not have an oven here?
Becky, we have to do
this. Is that patent?
No. Probably some random video I saw on Facebook or something.
My daughter posted it.
Yeah.
Can I say one more thing really quick?
Yes.
So once a week, kind of like cleaning out the closet thing, we do like a really crazy fun organization task.
Fun for mom.
Yesterday, while I was at work, my kids got to sort through every sock in our entire house.
Oh, that is fun.
Because we have a really big sock problem, and I'm like, we're done with socks. Everyone gets a certain amount of socks, and we're gonna, but anyway.
Sorry, raise your hand if you have a sock problem.
Oh, man.
That is everybody's problem.
Yeah.
That's a whole broadcast.
Oh, yeah.
How you deal with socks.
For real.
Let's talk laundry.
For real, because I have a tip with that, but we won't go into it.
Ooh.
Did you pin yours together?
No, I tried that.
I know somebody else who pinned them together.
Nope, it's the mesh bag. Mesh bags, zippered mesh bags. David got them on Amazon. There's my tip.
Oh, I should do that.
He's obsessed with it, and I haven't gotten on board yet, but I'm like, oh, I get it. Like,
yeah.
I get why that works. But
so you put them all in there, and then
so everybody puts their own socks in the mesh bag.
Oh.
Their own mesh bag.
Their
each
own
person has their own mesh bag.
Oh,
yeah.
Yes.
Right?
Mesh bag.
Hashtag be your favorites.
We
get
super excited about
a link to the mesh bag.
I love it. Because my problem is I do a load of laundry and I have 8 socks and none of them match any of the others because they haven't made it into the laundry basket
totally.
Or something.
Or the sock got stuck in and some.
There is something. Yeah. There is something that takes the socks out.
The reason, I wouldn't have thought of those mesh because they always call them lingerie bags. Yeah. If they call them a sock bag, I have two socks in them.
Lingerie bags. I think I could use those.
Anyway, so we end up with a big giant basket full of random socks. So they spent, I think, 2 hours, all my kids together.
Yeah,
they were allowed to listen to music. I was here at work. Mm-hmm. They had to send me pictures of the piles when they were done. And then
it's so funny because my son just does that for fun.
Oh,
he does.
Yes.
Yes, I can see that.
Our socks.
Yeah, every once in a while.
And we just had that random basket too. And I said, whatever is left in this basket after you guys are done, it is
done.
Yeah. Done. I'm done.
Tell me how you felt.
I was so done.
Show me how you.
How did you feel when you threw them away?
Oh my god!
So good.
Liberated.
No, I was like, I bet it was like, whoo.
Oh yes, it was. Yes.
Okay, so we need to be done. So this is the last thing that I was just going to share is that this isn't as much of a family thing, but. You probably know and have caught on to the fact that I've been catching up a lot in my kids' albums, and I started with one child at a time, started with Porter, caught up, shared about it on the blog, and next is Claire. Well, different than Porter, Claire wants to be involved. Hey, Race. Claire wants to be involved, and so she and I are, that's one of the things that we are going to do together this summer, and so for any of you who are feeling inclined to work on your kids' scrapbooks, to catch up, to get rid of, to eliminate, and then preserve kind of a smaller selection of what you do want to keep. All of that is shared on my blog, and you can just search catching up. And in fact, you can search catching up, Becky Higgins catching up on YouTube, and there's three videos that are sharing exactly what I've done. So if you are just in that mindset, there you go. That's what I'm going to be doing. Anything else? All right, what's our next broadcast?
Ooh, it's on Tuesday!
Oh my
What are you doing on Tuesday?
I'm just answering the people's questions, making their dreams come true.
And
don't get too hyped up about it.
Oh, come on. And what's
next? I'm just going to curl my hair live. So exciting. It could be very boring, but
no.
If you ask me questions, like, there are some people that want to know things about me.
Yes.
Like, what makeup I use, and you can just ask those questions, and
they
I'll tell you.
They can even ask customer service questions as well.
And it's scary, because it's live, and sometimes I just need to just shut my mouth.
No.
And don't be somebody out there to smack me down.
I'm going to smack you.
No, we're excited. So it's Wendy on Tuesday. What time do we know?
11.
11.
The same time? Okay, so 11 Pacific time. Yeah. So mark your calendar if you're interested in seeing how she gets this amazing look. And she will make all of your dreams come true and answer all of your questions, and it will be fun.
Yes.
Yeah.
And I'm sure some of you are totally annoyed. But
I was.
That I'm not going to be talking about scrapbooking, because that is what we do. But
that's not what we talked about today.
Once in a while, we'll put some cards in there.
You guys know. We don't.
I'll get on and ask scrapbooking.
Yeah, there you go.
Perfect. We could talk about the app.
Yeah.
Yes.
There you go. I'll ask app-related questions.
Yes.
While I'm here.
Wendy represents our customer service for the Project Life app. So she will answer those questions, not the technical ones. All right, so we're going to be done. We're thankful for Monique for being here.
And I'm thankful for you for letting me be here.
Special guest. And we're thankful for Race pushing the button to end this. We're thankful for Tony, who fielded questions and comments. And most of all, we're thankful for you guys. We love that you're here with us. We love your engagement. And share this if you feel like these summer tips are useful to other people that you know.
Or if you just find us comical and think that other people should know that.